in Christ?
Yes.
Do you love Jesus, Josh?
Yes. Why? I love him. Because he survived for us and he died for us.
That's right. Now, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Nothing?
I like to go to New York with my family because I like the stuff that we go. And last time we go, I grew up and that was horrible. And we met Santa Claus. We go to the M&M store and the Disney store today.
My favorite part is spending time with my family in New York and going to stores and seeing Santa Claus. And I like having family time with my
family.
Well, today is the day we finally get to go on our Christmas family vacation. We started a tradition last year where we're taking the children to New York. Last year was dynamic. We got to go see the Rockettes, Rockefeller Center. It was just good family time. I'm excited today. The kids have been pumped up for a few weeks now. I'm as pumped up as I can be. I'm ready to sit on the airplane and relax, but family time is good. This time of year is amazing. It reminds us just of the special gifts. The gift giving is nice, but the best gift you have outside of Christ is your family. And stealing away with them and just sitting back and laughing and watching movies and walking and exploring and seeing amazing new things, that's what I'm looking forward to. I'm looking forward to ice skating, seeing the tree in Rockefeller Center, sitting in a hotel, having cocoa, just enjoying time with my family. So I'm excited. We're getting ready to go. I'm going to board the plane, sit back, relax, take a nap, and jump up and be ready to explore. I'm so ready to enjoy the Langston family for Christmas in New York.
I've experienced a lifestyle of living what they preach, family time. It matters to show the interaction, to show them love, that they take time for each other, they have family time, they talk amongst dinner. I've never seen that. So it is something to behold, to take back to my house, you know, where I want to interact more with my husband, you know, sit down and how's your day, those things, you know, things that sometimes we take for granted. What you putting in it?
Mommy said not all of them.
Put four. Bag is full. Four. Thanks. Just gotta go in Gabby's luggage. It's full. You know, the small things, taking time for each other. That's the most important. You think I'm not looking right?
What you packing?
Here I have my little toys, my TV, my candy, and my book. As like I'm bringing my Uno card so I can play with my mom and my sister and my brother and my dad. And then I brought candy because I will be hungry on the plane, and I have headphones so I can listen to the TV on the airplane.
What I'm looking forward to is spending quality time and family time with my family and enjoying one another and not having other people around, maybe others that go to a church, and just me, my family, having a great time and having fun, singing Christmas songs in the car, or even just having quality time together in the room and watching movies and just having a blast.
And hit the subscribe button to see more of my cool videos. Bye, everyone.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Yours truly, Clarence Langston. Excited, me and the family were getting ready to do a trip to New York, a family tradition that we do on a yearly basis. Just getting over last night. Last night was incredible. We had a leadership Christmas party at Word Nation Christian Center, and to see the smiles and beautiful faces, and we celebrated Christ, we celebrated each other. And so now this is what I do the day after. I'm getting my family together. My little guys, they downstairs excited. My daughter, you know, teenagers, 14 years old.
Is it due today, Gabby?
Hi, Daddy.
Is it due today?
I mean, it was just like, it was reflecting on a project that we did. And it's due today.
She down there trying to work on a paper while we're on our way out the door to the airport to get her homework in. But it's an exciting day. My wife is excited. She's moving us all along. You know how that is. You know, women, you know, they rush a little bit more than we do. Well, they got to do a whole lot more, but it's amazing. It seems like as soon as we get down to the final 10 minutes to get out the door, she starts rushing. That's all part of the excitement. My children, boys, woke up early this morning, and they've been running around the house with their Christmas hats on, and my daughter is usually the last one to get up. Again, 14 years old. I don't know what happens. It's like an alien comes down and steals our children when they turn into youth. But I tell you, I love my children. I love my family. What a wonderful time it is as we celebrate Christmas. But I believe every day is Christmas. Every day we should think about the goodness and the mercies of God and just all of the sacrifices that He made for us. The Bible says God loved us so much, He gave His only begotten Son that you and I could have life and have it the more abundantly. And that's what this is all about. Many times you see me ministering and see me on television and hear me on radio, or you may come out to Word in Action and hear me minister, preach, or teach under the unction of the Holy Spirit on Sunday or Tuesday night Bible study. But it's not every day that you come into my life, that you come into my home, and you get a chance to see that the life that I live behind the scene. Many times we get on a platform and we turn on and we're something different when we turn off. But this is who I am. I love God. I love my wife. I love my children. I love life. And so we're getting ready to go. Man, I'm about to do what I normally do. I'm about to go downstairs. Have some of my spiritual sons are going to come and grab my last bag. And we're going to go downstairs and pray. You heard Pastor Robin. She's hollering up the stairs. It's 12:20. We got to get to the airport. So I'm going to go downstairs. We're going to do what we always do. We pray before we leave. All right, y'all, come on, follow us down. Love you guys. Hey, it's going to be a great time, I tell you. Hey, Elder Damon, everybody ready? Children in the car? No. Come on, let's get ready to go, guys. Let's get to the airport. I don't care how many times I say it, it's the last moment. Once we get on the airplane, everybody settles down. The boys pull out their CD player, or DVD players, and watch a movie or color. And I can pull out a book, close my eyes for a moment, kind of meditate. So we got a certain books that I love to travel with. Let me see. Where is... I don't know where I put the book. Moment. My wife is going to be calling my name. I got to hurry up, guys. Hey, let's get ready to pray. Let's get ready to pray. All right, let's go. Let's go, guys. All right, let's go. Let's go. I'm going to have to do
it.
All right, guys.
Daddy!
Come on, let's pray.
We'll be late.
All right. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this is surely your day. This is your family, the Langston family. We're so grateful for this opportunity to come boldly before you. We thank you for traveling mercies. We thank you for your grace being upon us. We thank you for your angels going ahead of us, surrounding us, being around about us, covering the airplane with the blood of Jesus. Traveling mercies, we decree and declare. Thank you for the open door. Thank you for the open heaven. Thank you for the open window. Thank you for blessing us when we come and when we go. Thank you that our home is in divine order. Thank you that Gabrielle, Jonathan, Joshua, me, and Pastor Robin, that we're in divine health and we have a great time, Lord God. No weapon that is formed against us shall be able to prosper. We thank you for all of our family and friends being covered with the blood of Jesus. Father God, we thank you right now, Lord God, that we make it to our plane on time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We're on the road this morning. We're here to take care of the first family, get them to the airport. I'm about to go take his car to the gas station right now, get it gassed up, get it all clean and prepared so when the first family gets in, it's a smooth and clean transition. We'll be back in a minute.
I'm Minister Mike Wells. I've been serving the man of God for over 12 years. I've been with him for over 22 years. And, you know, it is such an honor and a privilege to be able to serve him because he's taught me so much. He's imparted so much, so many different aspects. But, you know, right now we're loading him up to get ready to go on a very important vacation. He's taught us how to vacation, how to enjoy family time, how to get away, how to unplug, how to reconnect, how to, you know, just have downtime. And family time is so important. You know, I just love the Langston because they teach us so many fundamental principles about what it is to relax, what it is to enjoy each other, what it is to bond and connect and just be yourself, you know what I'm saying, and just let go of the day-to-day activities of life and just kind of reconnect with each other. And so it's just been a blessing and an honor to serve him.
Hey everybody, I'm back. Got the truck all gassed up. Concierge team has just pulled up. We're about to get Bishop First Family's bags loaded. Just stay tuned. We got a lot going on this morning.